more encouragement from our educational institutes for going ahead with such projects. And we've realized that financially, there is not much support coming in from the government side. Even currently, whatever has been supported by NITTR may not be sufficient because designing a prototype is always much more costlier. We say that the project has cost us around 10 to 12,000, but we've spent almost double that amount or a little more than that trying to get components from the cheapest places or bargaining with people and trying to get the components. So maybe if support is little there, freely available with time and with finance more so, it'll be really a good boost to Goan students. And it shows that our Goan students are no less on the national platform.
So first of all, we have taken 100 square meter area. So we have taken different kind of system, like we have drip, we have micro, and we have sprinklers over there. So first we have taken the this. Farmers choose different kind of irrigation. So whichever he like to choose, he can choose from there, as per him. So first we have drip irrigation. We have made a section of 10 channels, and we have placed one solar line. And second, we have micro of 2 channels with one solar line, and we have different 3 sprinklers division with 3 solar lines. So it is cost effective, portable, and it is beneficial for the farmers in rural area, because we can see the farmers are facing lots of problem over here. So it's better for them. We are using solar energy. We are using solar panel of 24 watt, and it is good. Like, we are using renewable energy rather than non-renewable energy, because it will long last till longer rather than that energy going to finish soon. So other things, secretary part gonna explain by Aaron. Thank you.
Do you think that the Goa government should support you for this?
Yeah, we should think that Goa government should support our farmers, so that it should, agriculture should become a must thing in Goa.
No, for this project.
Because it's beneficial, and we can make a commercial product of it, so that Goan farmers and other state farmers should get benefit from it.
Whatever we have done, we would like to demonstrate it, because we are thinking about people. We have done this project. There is this innovation contest which was organized by NITTR Kolkata. We had registered in the month of October. In September we had to register, and then various elimination rounds were there. So through the all the process, we have all the rounds we have cleared, and finally last month they have said that we are finally selected for the grand finale. So this project has gone through a lot of elimination rounds, and finally they have liked the idea and they have accepted it. And this innovation contest will be held from February 23rd to 24th 2019. Now what we have done? We know that technology has increased and it's vast. It has reached to its height, but it is not reaching the rural people. So if we see village people, there are many things which are advanced and which can be easily adopted by them, but it does not reach to them. So we have made a smart irrigation system, and not just smart, but it is cost effective too, and especially keeping in mind rural agriculture, that is rural people. So what we have done in that, we say we need to save water, we need to save energy, and we say that labor cost is also more. And also we have seen that many people who have agricultural land, they get other jobs, and they leave that, they sell that field, or they don't go into agriculture. So keeping all these things in mind, we thought we can compile all these things into one system. That is what we have done. So we are in this, we are saving energy by using renewable source of energy. We are saving water by giving water to the plants at different stages of growth. That will be explained by my students. And also by using drip irrigation, and any type of irrigation we can use here. This system can be applied for any type of irrigation, any type of crops. Maybe going from small spinach to maybe spinach, coriander to coconuts and mangoes, the same system can be used. So this flexibility we have given, and also saving energy, as I have told, and saving water, and labor cost is reduced because this pump, what we are going to use is solar pump, and it is just 24 watts and working on 12 volts, and I think it is much less than what we use 1 HP, 2 HP pump in the fields. There are many technologies and vast fields used for commercial all AC motors and all, but here we are using brushless DC motor pump. So it is saving the cost. The product cost also will be told by my students. And we are a team of 5 members. Okay, we have a head of department who is the faculty member there in the electronics department, Ms. Reena Fernandez, our students, Mr. Kiran, Mr. Yasin, and Mr. Aaron. They have continuously worked hard. Since October, we are working hard to make this project a success. And today you will see that this project has worked success. And looking at the cost and the amount of circuitry and the flexibility, I think you should be surprised.
How much area it can cover?
For now, we have considered an area of 100 square meters. You can scale it up. The only thing is number of sections should be increased, only the pipe length, and the scalability is maybe if you increase by 50% more, the cost will just increase by 10%.
How much will the cost?
Around 12,000.
Okay.
So I request my students to...
Video journalist Alfred Fernandez from Margao for HCN.